Our Daily World, our Daily Advertiser, and our Morning Advocate. Mm-hmm. They ran some beautiful stories.
So many of the first responders that died makes a second layer to this that kind of gets a real kinship with all our firemen here, because you know how many times, you know, they go out to try to help people, and you know, ambulance people, policemen, priests. I saw the first responder that was killed was a priest there giving last rites who got caught up in the thing. So just to show you, all the people who go to help people whenever they're in need.
We had a lot from this area here.
That went to help afterwards.
And then Louisiana donated, what was it, 2 fire trucks?
At least one for sure.
I think maybe they had one after that. And at just about the same time, this was Sunday, September 11th, mm-hmm. a real nice article here, Nieces Remember Lieutenant Marion Dufio. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if you had a chance to read that. There was a ship named after mm-hmm. Opelousas World War II hero. Very interesting article. It fits in good with what we're talking about. He got killed in an airplane.
Welcome back, KSLO.
He was shot down in the Second World War.
Sure,
and
he
must have been some hero for them to name a ship after him within a matter of maybe just a year or two later.
If you go to O'Hare Airport, there's a memorial to O'Hare himself there, and also Dufio is featured within the memorial as well. We featured him as a character in the St. Andrew Church Cemetery tours just a couple of years ago. Charlie Roy played him.
I remember that. I attended that.
It's a good way to learn your history. Of course, that's coming up the 2 middle weekends again this October. I'll give you all the details at times and all, but it'll be the 2 middle weekends. We'll have the tour, and you better learn a lot about the history of all these important people.
And let me name the nieces that were shown in here. Boy, he was a nice-looking fellow. Right. They have a big picture of him right here. Anna Dufio Stelly is on the left in the picture. Jerry Dufio Cortez is in the center. And Rose Dufio, oh yeah, we know. I know her
very
for sure.
With the tours with us each year, her and her sister.
So,
and she also got one of the humanitarian awards, if I'm not mistaken, this past year at the Chamber of Commerce, if you remember.
So. That's correct. So anyhow, I want to thank our local Daily World for doing such a good job on keeping us up to date. Every time you read about this, you learn a little bit more.
2 big events Friday night. One is at 8:30 p.m. at Evangeline Downs Event Center. Sammy Kershaw is going to be playing with Mike Dean right here at Evangeline Downs, 8:30 p.m. Tickets at $25. You can go buy them ahead of time. The proceeds all go to Boys and Girls Club of Acadiana. And y'all been hearing about all the problems with the Boys and Girls Club here. This is part of the solution to try to generate some funding to help them out. Also that evening, just before that, if you go down to the Music and Market series, it's going to be the Dog Hill Stompers, which is Zydeco, and the vegetable is going to be okra. So go by there on your way to there.
Tour de Teche. And of course, that's the canoe race that's going to take place over 135 miles of the Little Teche. And it's going to start right here in Port Barry again, like it did.
We didn't get our canoe yet, you and I.
No, and we said it, but they
might be too late to train this year.
Very much too late. Now, the last day to the deadline to register is this Friday here, tomorrow. And the race itself will start, like I just mentioned, in Port Barry on October the 7th.
Right.
Should be a lot of fun. It's in 3 stages this year.
3 legs that way.
Instead of one long, long race, it's going to give some communities a little bit better. And while we're talking about Port Barry,
they got the birthday party
on next Saturday, mm-hmm. not this Saturday here, but next Saturday, September the 24th, from 10 to 2 o'clock at the Veterans Memorial Park, Port Barry will be celebrating a birthday, 100 years old.
Polly Pickney will be 100 years old?
Oh, no, no.
Not Polly.
And
Gil. Is Gil's 100th birthday?
Yeah, Gil is the mayor there. But anyhow, it's a fun day, and, you know, it's nice that I didn't realize just how old Port Barry was. It was a very small town. What, probably 50 years ago,
it was,
60 years ago, it was a very small town. Today, it continues to grow.
It was that little town next to Frisco.
Yeah, that's correct.
How about some more sponsors? We've got to get a bunch in here. I'm running behind. How about Carl's Thrift Away, all your medicinal needs? If you just had your eyes worked on and you need some of that good salve that you got to put, some antibiotic type cream, Carl's Thrift Away's got that. They've got the big name brand one, if you've come
how about
with a name
the,
brand.
How about the stars?
That rubbed off on me. You caught it, man.
Sitting here.
Look how my eyes are beautiful compared to yours now. You see, yeah. I've got my little ointments and all, but Carl's Thrift Away, they can hook you up with all that type of stuff, and they can do the generics too. Maybe your health insurance pays 100% of generic products. They've got the generic drugs there as well at Carl's Thrift Away. Whatever you're looking for, they can compound multiple medicines together. They got a great gift shop, monogramming, gift wrapping. That's Carl's. And how about Dixie Storage? All your storage needs throughout St. Landry Parish, they can help you with locations in Port Barry, Opelousas, and Washington. They've got big warehouses if you want to get the whole warehouse. If all you're looking for is the little individual units, you know, just a person at home wants to have a nice, secure, well-lit, concrete, clean way to get in and out of your own little storage for your own home stuff, they got that. They've also got two restaurants right now, Felice, in the Port Barry area, right on Highway 190. I see that they're expanding some of their storage. Stanford Contracting was busy. They started laying the foundation for some new warehouses in Port Barry. So they can help you with, if you're a small business, big business, Fortune 100, Fortune 5 companies use them. Yeah. So go buy.
ExxonMobil is a big tenant there. And of course, PPG was for a number of years using their storage. And there's a couple of other big oil companies. I just said ExxonMobil. That's the same company.
Don't forget A-Plus Glasses. It's the company locations in Lafayette and in Opelousas.
Okay.
And how about this? One last thing. This is a little early, but I'm going to bring it up because I just got the email from Mr. Joe Hidalgo, who's with the Opelousas Sunrise Rotary. Now, you and I just saw Kip. The president with
Kip Bertrand,
the president with St. Landry Bank here, filming some spots to help promote the Rotary.
St. Landry Homestead Bank.
Yeah, okay.
Ooh.
Yeah, let me get that right.
Let me
St.
get
Landry
that right.
St. Landry Homestead. I see him so fast.
Yeah.
They're kind of similar. I got it. Homestead. He's with the Homestead. He was talking about doing some charity work with the Rotary. And one of the things that the Rotary does, the Opelousas Sunrise Rotary, when you go vote in Ward 1, anywhere in Ward 1, it doesn't matter what the election is, they put boxes out for a food drive. Anytime there's a voting, so we remind you, the voting's not until October 22nd, okay, this next election.
But that's soon.
So I'm letting you know now, put some cans aside, buy you some cans, bring it when you vote and put it down. Just make that part of your routine that when I'm going to vote, I'm going to bring at least a couple of cans with me. And it all goes to the Opelousas Food Bank. So give them a hand.
Kip will be featured in an ad that is going to be running to advertise it on the television station here. The Advocate Football Edition every year.
Uh-huh.
And I read this article of this Bobcat.
That's the brand.
Bobcat brand. And I just decided to call Mike Abshaw over at the Lafayette Abshaw Mower Sales and Service.
It's one of those zero-turning radius
mowers.
Zero
turn. And some real nice, the price is low as $4,599. Mm-hmm. And that's a big cut. I forgot what the width, I think it was 48. And I spoke to him and I said, what really I like to know about these is what type of engine it has. And it has a Kawasaki engine on it. And of course, we bought over the years over at Oye Tractor Implement, which is now Quality Implement. We bought a number of their machines and they had Kawasaki's on them. Maybe everything else wore out but the motor. So I told that to Mike, he was glad to hear that. So in Lafayette.
They let the good times roll, right? Kawasaki lets the good times roll. Remember those old ads in the 70s?
We just
said your name on the air.
Just talked about you.
Good morning. There he is.
Yeah, he was all dressed up in red. You're not from Port Barry, are you?
That's Port Barry blue. We got Dr. Kerry Thibodeau. I want to remind you some of our other sponsors. Dr. Kerry Thibodeau, who is a board-certified surgeon. Anything that you need from appendectomies to breast biopsies, from gallbladders to colonoscopies, you can go and see Dr. Kerry Thibodeau. You know, when you go to see your primary care physician, and you know, he says, well, you have to have surgery for something. You can ask who that surgeon is. You know, you say, well, could you send me to this particular surgeon? Dr. Kerry Thibodeau, 20 years of general and vascular surgical practice, varicose veins, the healing type stuff he does with the wound. Womb Treatment Center. He's the man.
And when Kelly had her back surgery recently, he performed one portion of the back surgery, and then Dr. Ray Williams performed the other portion of the back surgery. And, you know,
sometimes you don't even perceive who the doctors is
that
are helping.
That's correct. Most people wouldn't realize that Dr. Williams handles portion of it, and Dr. Thibodeau handled that one. And I might add, she's back at work and still has some effects. You know, it's still
takes a while to heal.
She went to the football game the other night, so I guess she's getting better.
Must be good enough.
Yeah, just took it easy, she said. Now, this is nice, good news right here. Let's see, city buses, how many they bought? Five. They bought five new buses fueled by compressed natural gas right here. That's for the Lafayette Transit Service. And beautiful rigs. It's going to be pretty. And the fact that I'm trying to point out here is that they're going to be using natural gas. And, of course, the service companies that operate throughout the world, international, most of them have an office in Lafayette. And, of course, they're in that Haynesville field and the big field in South Texas and over near, and for that matter, they're all the way up in Pennsylvania and Utah and all over. But I'm glad to see that, and they're building the station for this, and they're going to build a real fueling station, and they're going to sell fuel there for other people that have vehicles that can use it.
And you can multi-use your vehicle with natural gas, is my understanding. You can have a car that you can flip from gas to gasoline. So it's kind of interesting.
So Lafayette, proud of you.
LHC Group, all your home health care needs. LHC Group can help you with everything from hospice work, palliative work. If you're looking for home health care with the nursing, the equipment, the beds, the special chairs, the oxygen gear, they can do all that. They can get therapists to go in your house, nursing to get inside your house, all throughout the United States. And they've also got their care units in Opelousas General Hospital, over Lafayette General Hospital, that if you're good enough to not need the heavy hospital care, but not quite good enough to go home yet, that intermediate phase, they specialize in that as well. And don't forget about the Wellness Center over here. If you're looking to work out and stay in shape, they've got that over in Opelousas off Heather Drive, Louisiana Healthcare Group. All about helping people.
The Chittimacha Tribe over in Charrington, I guess, would be, or Generette, near the Generette area. The Chittimacha Tribe chairman, John Paul Darden, who I had a picture of, 2 weeks ago, when they sponsored the boxing matches over at their facility there. And last week, they donated $161,000 to charities in the area. We need to get our name on that.
I saw Lafayette Charities getting it. As part of the New Life Center over here was one of the recipients. So
we need to get...
We got to go to a radio break. TV and radio, folks.
We'll finish this when we come back on.
We'll see you on the other side of three.